You guys
Sometimes
worried?
The best Celia Ward can do for worried children's literacy is a kind of first aid.
Sandy.
Before she can teach the toddlers at her childcare center to read, she has to take on the crippling hardships they bring with them.
I had a father tell me, he said, I actually don't know how to be a father. He said, because it don't come with a manual. So what I see with early literacy is we need help.
A report by the Annie E. Casey Foundation ranked Mississippi last in literacy, along with New Mexico, among the 50 American states. Few places have it worse than Moorhead. Across the U.S., literacy has been on the rise, but the gap between rich and poor keeps getting wider, and that hits especially hard here in the Mississippi Delta, the poorest part of the nation's poorest state.
It's been said that if you could take the Delta out of Mississippi, the numbers would go way up, you know, from what you're seeing. And that is true.
For some, strong parenting overcomes poverty. Librarian Valerie Fairley is putting her daughter Tatiana through college and enrolled grandson Ryan in a reading program at 3 months. She dedicated this book to him.
Learning to read and becoming educated at an early age is very crucial because it gets our people out of their cycle of poverty.
For others, there are some state programs. April May runs Mississippi Building Blocks, a state agency aimed at preschoolers and daycare centers.
Children at that age are like a sponge, and they soak up everything that you give them.
Where's her elbow, Caleb?
Where it operates, the program has lifted reading rates, but it operates in just a few dozen of the state's 1,700 daycare centers on a budget of $3 million, about 1% of the state's budget for prisons. In the rest of the state, parents can hope for someone like Celia Ward.
You pay your employee, you pay your bills, and there's nothing left. So what do?
So this seems to... Wait. Sure.
But the strain is showing.
Where will Sam
John Hendren, Al Jazeera, Moorhead, Mississippi. Again?